You look gorgeous.
Thank you.
Who are you wearing?
Louis Vuitton.
And who's making your earrings and necklace?
Cartier.
Cartier.
Yeah.
Oh, very good.
Did you know that the average annual salary in America stands at about $47,000? Safe to say that Millie Bobby Brown is living no average life. At 16 years old, she is the highest paid actor in the Netflix original Stranger Things. Yes, she gets paid even higher than the famous Winona Ryder. Sources say that this young actress rakes in somewhere between $300,000 to $350,000 for every Season 3 Stranger Things episode that she appears in. That puts her overall earning at around $4 million, not factoring in the income she gets from sponsorships and endorsement deals either. So today we're going to take a look at how Millie Bobby Brown spends her millions. But before that, a simple reminder on how to enter our brand new giveaway. We will be giving away either an iPhone X Max, the new iPad mini, or a MacBook Pro. It's all your choice. So be sure to leave a like, comment the keyword, subscribe, and turn on notifications to enter the giveaway. It's really that simple. First, the family mansion. Photographs of Brown's family house have circulated online like wildfire. And while we're not really sure if it was the Stranger Things star who bought it for the enjoyment of her family, it's most likely that everyone in the household pitched in to pay for it, given that it came with a hefty price tag that sits at $900,000, and that's just the house. The entire cost could have easily gone well over $1 million if you include all of the appliances, furniture, and fixtures inside. One really impressive thing about Millie Bobby Brown is that she's able to keep most of her privacy intact, even though she's really, really famous. This is why we haven't really gone on a comprehensive virtual tour of their family's mansion, but thanks to the YouTube videos and Facebook stories she shoots in her own bedroom, in the garden where she sometimes does yoga, and in the front porch where she loves to practice her modeling, we've gotten a sneak peek of what the interior of the house looks like, and looking at all the furniture, decor, and the magnificent pool we've spotted, incidentally, none of them look cheap. Next is property tax. Owning just one lot in sunny Los Angeles amounts to sky-high property taxes. How much more if your mansion sits on more than one? Sources say Millie Bobby Brown shells out as much as $7,000 every year just for property tax. That seems hefty, but for someone who earns $350,000 for one episode, this is chump change. What isn't chump change, though, is how much she spent on cars. So next we have her Cadillac Escalade, which is nearly worth $100,000. She is often seen leaving premiere nights, award nights, and social gatherings in this luxury getaway car, which gets up to a maximum speed of 210 kilometers per hour. What a 16-year-old would need a car like this for is beyond us. But given all the joy she's given us with her magnificent acting, we can only be too happy for her. If you think that Millie's only got one car, though, then you haven't been paying attention. We're talking about show business's highest paid 16-year-old girl here. So next is when Millie Bobby Brown also spent a sizable portion of her cash on a Mercedes-Benz V-Class Marco Polo, which cost about $70,000. Sources say she also has a $52,000 Ford and a $27,000 Mini Cube. I know what you're thinking. Millie Bobby Brown is just a baby. Is she even allowed to drive? Well, I know this might make you feel like you're a few hundred years old, but actually, yeah. Millie Bobby Brown now has a learner's permit and is legally allowed to drive. I know, right? Pretty crazy. The next thing that Millie Bobby Brown spends her millions on is a bit more age appropriate. We're talking about luxury pajamas. For the most recent holiday, MBB got herself a set of Sleeper's famous feather-lined nightwear, which really could have become the influencer's best glam ensemble when shooting home videos. See, it looks so comfy and so glamorous at the same time. Millie Bobby Brown also wore the famous crepe de chine aboard what seemed to be a private jet, and we think it's the most fabulous pajama selfie we have ever seen, ever. Millie Bobby Brown's one heck of a model after all, and if you want to steal this look, you can have your own set of PJs for $320. This look is actually so last year, now that the whole world is basically in quarantine and everyone's mandated to work from home and practice social distancing. Millie Bobby Brown has been shooting her promos from home. And so another era of luxury sleepwear has emerged. Millie's fans were delighted to see that the young girl looked healthy amid all these global health concerns when she posted a short clip of herself at home petting her adorable dog. What fans really noticed was the young actress's outfit, which really made her look like a rock star kid from the 90s. She wore a tie-dye bandana, baby pink sunnies, and a pair of oversized Drew House pajamas, which she bought from her favorite designer, Justin Bieber. Clothes from Drew House are never cheap, and the Theodore top Millie Bobby Brown sported was extra special and costs about $100. That's already prom-level outfit budget for the rest of us, but again, Millie is not the rest of us.
Being a young woman today, I guess, is learning and developing. I'm being myself.
Next, we have Pandora Jewelry. Steal Her Style made an exhaustive list of all the most iconic outfits Millie has ever worn, and we were stunned to see just how much she loved to accessorize with Pandora. MBB has a $90 bracelet, a pair of $55 hoop earrings, a $25 safety pin brooch from All Pandora, and she wore all of it at once for a photo shoot. She also has a pair of classic Pandora earrings, which cost about $50. But we spotted some personalized charms incorporated in her pair, which would have made it all the more expensive. Next on the list of other high-end accessories aside from Pandora, Millie Bobby Brown also seems to love Messica jewelry, which is simply one of the finest, most expensive, and dreamiest accessories that the rest of us can only dream of having. For instance, Brown once wore a mauve addiction pave earrings from Messica, which has a huge price tag of $3,930. She also paired it with a My Soul bracelet, also worth more than $3,000. And if that isn't enough, she threw in Glamazon Double Pave, which can be bought at a staggering $6,600. If we do the math, that's almost $15,000 just for accessories, and just for one day. But of course, we're not done yet. In fact, next on this list, we have her extensive collection of Louis Vuitton bags and pouches. In an Instagram post, MBB flaunted an LV multi-pochette accessories bag, which retails for almost $1,640. She was also spotted walking around a New York red carpet wearing a Louis Vuitton surreal striped dress. But it seems Millie Bobby Brown's favorite luxury brand is not LV or Messica. Instead, it would be Calvin Klein and Givenchy. Next on the list, we have the all-super high-end outfits she wore not just to Hollywood's best-attended social gatherings, but even at casual hangouts. Like that time she wore a Givenchy pack, which cost about $625, just for her trip to the airport from a hotel in downtown New York. It was even more expensive than the Givenchy cutout slingback heels she wore for the Godzilla 2 premiere in Paris, which was bought for $525. She did pair that one with another Givenchy piece. A couture spring dress designed in 2019 to be a little more luxurious. At the MTV Music Awards of 2017, the young actress sported a simple white Calvin Klein sleeved dress, which appeared to have been customized for her. She again wore a white number from CK when she attended the Emmy Awards in September that same year, but this one had a larger skirt, which made MBB look like an actual princess. Not one year has passed by since then that the teenage superstar didn't wear a CK piece to a red carpet event, showing her biases when it comes to branding. That doesn't mean Millie does not spend a fortune on other names and artists. For instance, we all loved it when she wore that flowy gold Dior gown for the London premiere of Godzilla 2. It made the alien look like royalty, but it couldn't have been cheap. From the custom fitting to the intricate embroidery, this off-shoulder look could have set Millie back a few thousand dollars at least, and it's good that she looked like $1 million walking in it. Brown also has an ultra-rare Christopher Kane crystal fringe patent clutch, which still sells for over $1,000 these days. Not that any one of us could just go out and buy one anytime soon. When it comes to tops, Millie also doesn't like sparing a dime. I mean, who can forget that time she strutted to the set of Jimmy Fallon's show wearing a high-neck satin top from Prada, which she paired with a panorama motif Duchesse skirt, also from the same designer house. These oohs, ahs, and wows from the audience and from Fallon himself better be worth it, since that entire ensemble cost over $4,500. Another notable top worn by Brown is the Nasty Gal Check It Over long line coat, which looks extremely good, but is surprisingly affordable at $80.
This kind of shows. I take my shoes off. I don't like having shoes on. Shoes are not my thing.
Next, we're going to take a look at designer shoes. Here are some of the most expensive shoes MBB has been sported wearing. A Sam Edelman Yarrow ankle strap sandal heel at $100. A Roger Vivier Twinkle Star suede platform sandals at over $1,000. A pair of Valentino rock stud cage sandals at little over $1,000. And a Christian Laboat Rantelot or Lato satin sneakers for about $800. Millie also has sensible shoes. And by sensible shoes, we mean $68 Chucks, $262 Pierre Hardy pumps, and Sophia Webster sandals. A British citizen who was born in Spain and is now working in Hollywood is bound to make a lot of flights. So almost half of the pictures we see on Millie's Instagram stories feature her on a plane or in a cruise or in a cabin somewhere. The girl is always flying, and we're quite surprised she hasn't bought her own plane yet, like the Kardashians that she loves and admires so much. To be honest, it may just be a matter of time before she does. For now, MBB loves flying business class, and we're sure that doesn't come cheap either. Sometimes when she flies, Millie Bobby Brown flies to exceptionally luxurious vacations that could take a lifetime of saving up if we were to go. One time when she was just 15 years old, she flew to the Suneva Fushi Resort in the Maldives and spent about $1,000 per night just for accommodations. It's the same resort where Joe Jonas and Sophia Turner spent their honeymoon. So you can just imagine how magnificent it was. Millie said she took this vacation to forget about the sour revelation of what would happen to Eleven at the end of season 2. Imagine having the money to fly to Maldives every time you had something you want to forget. I'll be glad to have problems if that's the case. So, as you can see, someone who earns the average annual salary for American workers in about an hour has a pretty good time spending her millions. If you weren't something close to that when you were 16, how would you have spent all of it? Some people wouldn't even know where to start. And you just know that Millie Bobby Brown isn't going anywhere anytime soon. so we can expect her to continue acting while making millions more and buying millions of more expensive items. Thanks for watching.